in jeder Stunde, an jedem Tag, nur zu denken an Deutschland, an Volk und an Reich, an unsere deutsche Nation.
This is a very difficult vote. This is probably the hardest decision I've ever had to make. Any vote that might lead to war should be hard. But I cast it with conviction.
We would be able to totally obliterate them.
You defeat ISIS across the region. The United States and our international coalition have been conducting this fight for more than a year. It's time to begin a new phase and intensify and broaden our efforts. Dismantle the would-be caliphate and deny ISIS control of territory in Iraq and Syria. That starts with a more effective coalition air campaign, with more allied planes, more strikes, and a broader target set. We need an immediate intelligence surge in the region. A more effective coalition air campaign is necessary, but not sufficient. And we should be honest about the fact that to be successful, airstrikes will have to be combined with ground forces actually taking back more territory from ISIS.
What would our response be? And I want the Iranians to know that if I'm the president, we will attack Iran. We would be able to totally obliterate
radical jihadist ISIS, a barbaric, ruthless, violent jihadist terrorist group, terrorism, terrorist, international terror network, terrorism, extreme terrorism, violent extremism, extremist groups, extremist jihadi, jihadists, jihadi, radicalism, Islamists, ISIS, Muslim Brotherhood, Hezbollah. We are at war, we are at war, barbarism, barbaric, vicious, lust for killing, Assad, Russia, and Iran, very dangerous places, nuclear weapon, Americans murdered, blood of Americans, mass shootings, massacre, genocide, people have been killed, killings, random killings, killed. Bin Laden, 9-11, it nearly destroyed us, people who wish us harm, threats and attacks. We were attacked. Where were we attacked? We were attacked. Terrorists who had attacked. Those are the decisions that are made by the president. We did try, without success, because of the Libyans' obstruction to our efforts.
We are standing with the people of Libya, and we will not waver in our efforts to protect them. As we came, we saw, we died.
In Libya, the U.S. intelligence community has said it's around 4,000 to 6,000. It's probably about doubled in the last 12 to 18 months.
Because of the Libyans' obstruction to our efforts.
When something bad happens, hey, it's those other guys, but wasn't I. Well, this is, you know, so yeah, she's grabbed onto Obama's ankle and hugged him tight. But if the polls start to show that he's trouble for her, then of course he's over the side. So that's the way she operates, that's the way Bill Clinton operated. If we want to put this in legal terms, she was an accessory before, during, and after the fact. Yes, Obama had the final decision. She was egging him on, she was cheering him on, she was pressuring him, and she went right along with it. One of the great things about this election, all American foreign policy has been questioned for the first time in quite a while. And that's all for the good. The couple of NATO, the couple of U.S. bases all over the place, the couple of U.S. troops all over the place. Maybe we're going to end some of that. We can all keep our fingers crossed anyway.
Wow.
Unconfirmed reports about Gaddafi being captured. Unconfirmed. Yeah. We've had too many. We've had a bunch of those before. We've had, you know, have had him capture a couple of guys.
We came. We saw. He died.
Did it have anything to do with your visit?
Oh, I'm sure it did.